manger de l'autocar avec ses jantes, avec ses phares. Ensuite j'ai fumé une berline, pures essences raffinées de benzine. Paris, j'aime ton gars.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Culinary Compass, and it is another cold but beautiful day here in New England. In winter, this is what we wish for. Today, I want to talk to you about how to make maple syrup candy in an incredibly fun way. Something that's done quite a bit in O Canada, which I learned about last year, and in fact, there is another Culinary Compass episode where you can see some of the pros doing this. Look below this video and you'll see that one. But today, we're gonna give it a try on our own. All right, so what do you need? Well, a couple of things. One is, you'll need a tray of some kind of type. All right, you're also gonna need maple syrup. Quality does matter in relation to the maple syrup. Use the highest quality maple syrup you can get your hands on. All right, next, you're going to need a pot. Something that you're going to be able to heat the maple syrup up in. You're going to need a candy thermometer so that you can heat the maple syrup to just the right temperature. We'll talk about that in a little while. You're going to need some kind of a spatula thing, which you can use to scoop the snow onto the pan and pat it down. And I'm going to show you how to do that also. And finally, what you're going to need is some type of a stick, some kind of maybe a bamboo or other type of very clean stick that we're going to be able to use to roll the maple syrup candy. Just going to use a simple shovel. I'm going to take the top layer of snow and get rid of it because we really want clean snow. Make sure not to get any snow that has, you know, dog pee in it. All right, so you're going to basically dump the snow on here, flatten it out. After you're done with that, you really want to pat this stuff down hard. You want it to be nice and compact. You're going to end up with a tray that will look somewhat like this. Okay, so now we're indoors. We've got our maple syrup. You've got a candy thermometer. Very important to actually know what the temperature is of the syrup that's going to be in your pot. As far as the kind of pot, I love to use a pot with a spout on it. You'll see why that's important a little later. This is basically a creuset. It's kind of like a cast iron with an enamel finish. The perfect kind of pot for this job. All right, so we got to put some syrup in here. Let's start off with that. Oh, the color of that. Mmm. Delicious. Okay, let's get our flame on. Definitely don't want to go too high, just a nice medium simmer. And it's going to take about maybe 5, 6, 7 minutes, but you need to stand here. Depending on your stove and the BTUs, the power of the flame, you got to keep an eye on it. We've got our candy thermometer, and since you're working with such a low quantity of syrup, and when you stick the candy thermometer in, you really can't get a reading. You'll need to just be creative and do a little bit of tilting to make this happen. All right, let's come back in a couple of minutes and we'll take a look at the temperature. All right, one thing you need to do is be really careful. First of all, hot maple syrup can burn you very easily. So keep your kids away, keep your hands away. Now take a look down here and you're gonna see that bubbles are starting to form and it almost feels like it's gonna overflow. If it is going to overflow, pull it off the fire and pour some of the maple syrup into a small container. It basically means you have too much maple syrup in for the size of the container. Remember, you need very little maple syrup, probably about 4 tablespoons for one really good looking lollipop. All right, we're checking our temperature here. We're at 230 right now. Softball heat, which is what we're looking for, is at around 235. So that's what we're shooting for, and we are there. We now have our warm maple syrup. We have our pan here with the snow. You want the snow to be kind of even on here before you do the pour, so try to flatten it out. And your next step is really very simple. All you're going to be doing is pouring the maple syrup onto the snow. So take a look. All right, we're gonna do another pour right now, a little bit maybe more controlled and slow. Olivia, can you start eating this immediately, or do you need to wait for it to cool down?
No, you don't need to wait for it to cool down because it's just been in the snow and it's collected a lot of that, so it's totally cool.
All right, now let's take a try and let's turn it. As you can see, if you do wait just a little while, and you'll have to experiment, it's hard to really know exactly how long, it involves issues around the temperature of the actual syrup, but once you're all done, you'll end up with your own little lollipop. And Olivia from the ABC Cafe told us we don't need to worry about how hot it is. Ah! Only kidding. That is really good. As you can see, really super simple and lots of fun. Let's do one more pour to show you how it's done. Olivia from the ABC Cafe is going to do the roll this time.
Okay, it's rolling. Beautiful.
All right, we've got our sticks all made. We're eating them and loving them, but there's a special way to do this. Olivia and Daniel, my son, and Olivia from the ABC Cafe have developed a very interesting method of increasing the pleasure quotient.
You can dunk it in the snow.
And you end up with kind of like a maple syrup slushy experience. It is actually kind of yummy. The other reason that this is a beneficial technique is it keeps the lollipop from getting too kind of stringy. Because once it gets stringy, it can become a problem. Have a fun time doing this. I highly suggest you go out and give it a try. It is so simple and so much fun and actually quite yummy. So, for the Culinary Compass, ciao for now. De nous faire inhaler ainsi parmi les squares et les allées de si dangereux.